from the Genesis Volatility's educational series on Everlasting Options, aka Forever Options. I'd like to thank Dave White from Paradigm for writing the initial white paper around Everlasting Options, and Samneet Chappal from Ledger Prime for the related works around his paper. If you're anything like me, you might be wondering, what is an everlasting option? A similar analogy can be made between a perpetual swap to a future and an everlasting option to a traditional option. The main selling point of the everlasting option is that it never expires. The everlasting option has a theoretical underlying option portfolio that creates the theoretical value of the everlasting option. But as this option portfolio does expire, the everlasting option, instead of having a rolling cost, will have a funding payment in order to roll to the new theoretical underlying portfolio. This theoretical underlying portfolio could be constructed many different ways, but we're going to talk about the original concept described in the white paper by Dave White. We'll explore theoretical pricing, funding, and some of the effects on the Greeks. The everlasting option described in the original white paper has a single strike as well as a daily funding rate. Now, the theoretical underlying portfolio for which we use to price the everlasting option uses a series of daily expiration options, all options of the same type, put or call, and all options of the same strike. So let's explore how to construct that underlying theoretical portfolio. The first step into creating this theoretical underlying portfolio is to create a series of options that expire every single day. Now, because most options venues don't have options that expire every day of the year, we need to interpolate the series. Meaning, we'll start with an option that expires in one day or less, and another option that expires in, say, 20 days, and we'll interpolate the implied volatility between each one of those data points. So now we'll have a series of options that expire in 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, so on and so forth, and we'll have the implied volatility for each one of those data points. The second step is to convert that implied volatility into a dollar price. Now that we have a dollar price, or a series of options dollar price, that expire every single day, we can now apply the weighting scheme. This weighting scheme theoretically can have any sort of different methods to it. But again, we're going to explore the one devised in the original white paper. The original white paper has a geometric sequence weighting scheme where the first option has a weight of 0.5 to the 1, or 1/2. The second option has a weight of 0.5 squared, or 1/4. The third option has a weight of 0.5 to cube, or 1/8, so on and so forth. This geometric weighting scheme will have a cumulative weight that asymptotes to 1 as you add all the weights together. Now, this is a very important distinction, and this is going to be the last distinction to this theoretical underlying portfolio. When we sum all the weights of all the theoretical options that underpin a portfolio, we're not going to count infinity options in this portfolio. We'll probably stop around 9. And so what we have to do is take the cumulative value and divide it by the cumulative weight, because the cumulative weight is going to be less than 1 because we didn't use infinity options. And dividing by the number that's less than 1 will scale up the portfolio value and back out the true theoretical value of the underlying option. And this is the portfolio that would underpin the pricing for the everlasting option. Let's explore funding payments. The fun part, funding payments. Now, how do we calculate funding payments for an everlasting option that never expires? If you are actually trading the underlying portfolio and holding that basket of options, well, every time an option expired in that basket, you would need to roll your portfolio and buy more options to rebalance your portfolio and have that constant exposure that you're seeking. The funding payment is really the replacement of that rolling cost, because you'll still have that exposure, but you won't need to go into the market and rebalance this whole basket of options. In broad terms, the funding payment value is going to be the difference between the old options portfolio that just experienced a partial expiration and the new options portfolio that just kicked in. That difference is going to be the funding payment. Digging into the details of the actual value of the funding payment, something that's particularly important to point out is that the option that's expiring in the old portfolio has a weight of 50%, and the other non-expired options in that portfolio are going to be all the options that compose the new portfolio. This makes finding the funding payment really simple. The funding payment, again, is going to be the difference in cost between the old portfolio and the new portfolio. And we know that the old portfolio has half of the options that create the new portfolio. So the new portfolio cost divided by 2, because the old portfolio has half of those options, minus 0.5 intrinsic value of the option that just expired. Because the option that just expired either has a value of 0 or it has an intrinsic value. And that option had a weight of 50%. And the funding payment is the difference between the old portfolio value and the new portfolio value. Taken all together, that's how we devise the funding payment of the everlasting option. Again, the funding payment of the everlasting option is just the rolling cost between the two theoretical portfolios. But the beauty of the everlasting option is that you get to carry this portfolio without ever incurring the fees of rolling. Let's go ahead and explore some of the properties of these everlasting options. The first interesting property about the everlasting option created using a geometric sequence weighting scheme is that just as the cumulative weights asymptote to 1 as we approach infinity options, well, the time-weighted duration or the time-weighted target maturity till expiration of the underlying portfolio approaches 2n, where n is the frequency of funding payments. And so if we're looking at a funding payment of 1 day, then the underlying portfolio will have an average weighted expiration of 2 days, because the 1 day option has a weight of 1/2, plus the 2 day option has a weight of 1/4, plus the 3 day option has a weight of 1/8, so on and so forth. The second interesting property of an everlasting option is that if we were going to price an everlasting call with a strike price of 0, well, then you start to have an option that mimics a perpetual swap, whereas the funding payments are similar to the payments of a perpetual swap. And so as your option becomes deeper and deeper in the money, you start to get exposure that resembles a perp more and more and more. The third and final interesting property of the everlasting option that we'll explore today is the exposure to the various Greeks. Because the everlasting option is composed of a basket of various underlying options, the Greek profile is going to be the cumulative exposure of that underlying basket. The underlying basket has various expirations, which all have their own sensitivities to the various Greeks, as well as a sensitivity to the term structure of the implied volatilities. So therefore, the underlying Greek exposure of the everlasting option will be dominated by different options in the basket in different environments. For example, in a low volatility environment, if the everlasting option is slightly out of the money, that first option in the basket, the one with the greatest weight, might actually have almost no impact to the Greek profile of the everlasting option. Whereas in a high volatility environment, where we're at the money, for example, that first option might be the biggest impact to the Greek profile of the everlasting option. And as the term structure shifts, or as the volatility regime changes, that Greek profile will change as well. Check out the set of tools we created for theoretical pricing of everlasting options at gvol.io, as well as a set of tools to measure and model the impact of the various Greeks under various volatility environments. I hope this video was helpful, and remember, find edge, capture alpha, and slang size.